Hello and welcome back to RoG-Gamer. New episode of Wild Castle Tower Defense. We are going to spend our talent points at the beginning. So everything goes here, max. This one, I think it's not enough. No, one more is missing. But we are already level 200. So, also here, the IF generator, we can upgrade. Let's try to go to level 100. And 10, I think it's the maximum now. 110. So, then here the archer, so that it's even. Here we have the gold mine and we can look for upgrading this, which is giving us 40% more. And I think the workshop, we can also max it out. So there we will have everything maxed out except the market, which is 50 million, which we need. Gold mine, I don't think that we will be pushing a lot there. So let's go for the castle. And I think one more time. 51, yeah. So what we are going to do is now we go back to the airship. We changed already the first one in the challenge. Here we could unlock also a few. We don't got till to Excalibur, but we are on the way. So let's have a look if we work this out. And as I told you already, this weekend I will start autoplay, so we will see where we will land on Monday. And probably I think it's around 300-400 the wave. But I don't know. I will just leave it on autoplay for the whole weekend. This looks easy for us. So then we go to the next one. A new talent, which is good for us. There we could unlock a new hero. I think this one also, we should be able to go through it. I think even to the stones, if I'm not mistaken, the red one is the first where we should be able to go through. But I don't know. Let's have a look. So, almost done this wave. And keep farming gold, that's good. That's what we need. And if you look at the archer, they changed also. We got now with some gray hats and green hats. So we got the Yeti. The yellow stone is it the first one. Yeah, so we got already some gray hats and blue uniforms, and here they go, gray uniforms and green hats. I don't know if the maximum, on the maximum I think it's yellow hats and gray uniform, but I'm not sure if it will change further. On my main account I got this at the moment. Yeah, this one looks also pretty good for us. Not even one monster can come into the circle of ice. So the IF generator is useless at the moment. We only use the archers. That's good for us. Not even the boss could go. So a new talent. Talents are always good for us. Because then we know where we can spend this talent points or level points. Almost halfway done. Yeah, now it's done. What is there? That boss from here, is that also a stone, a yellow stone, or what is it coming? Now we got two special mage which came, and they do everything faster. So all the enemies, monsters are going faster. Here at the moment, no one could hit us. It's this, the genie. Or something like that. He also got down, thankfully, to the IF generator. Let's try this one. So let's see how far we get. Then we can go to the colonies where we can try the same. So the last bosses, they couldn't hit us. I think this boss will hit us, but I'm convinced that the boss will not do enough damage that we are going to lose this battle. So 25% done. And boss is coming. The blue stone. Half-life done. And he don't hit it. So we are so strong that he cannot hit us. So let's go to this one. There was a number on the front which was telling us 225. I don't know if that means the wave that you should reach before you really get that down, or what does it mean? I have really no idea. Because for me, it looks like the strange of the this challenge. But I really have no idea. We are on wave 30 at the moment still. So we are going forward, but this weekend. And then next week we still keep on farming every day in order to advance the weekend coming on it. But yeah, this one is almost finished. Boss is coming, the redstone. He got 35,000, I think, if I'm not mistaken. Halfway. And he started hitting us. So now we should get in troubles with the next. If you look here, we got a number 125, 150. Here's 250, 325. I have no idea what it means. And I think you can also jump over to other battles. So you don't need them to do in the right order. But for sure, they are getting every time stronger, so it makes sense that you keep the order there. In the colonies, I think it's the same there. But it makes sense to really get one by one. So this one here, we see there are monsters which attacking us. So we have already lost some life. I think that's the archers which are attacking us because the other one don't come so close in order to do damage and hit the castle. So it's really the archer, this ones here which are coming, and if they are a lot and stay in line with other monsters in combination, the archers are going to attack Oh, my archers are going to attack the other monsters, maybe, and the archer have the possibility to shoot one or two times. But either way, we lost almost half life, and the other one will hit us faster than we defeat. So, violet one, no, purple is not working. Let's try this one. The green. This, I think, yes, we should be able. If the other, we were managing almost half life of him, this one, I think, really, we should be able, because I think 20, 15,000 life they get more than the one before. And as we can see here, we don't have any archers which are attacking us, so we don't lost any HP here. So this one looks good. It was the other one with the archers where we got problems. They came inside the circle of the IF generator, but we were too slow. Too slow with damaging them. So we need to upgrade the archers and also the castle for sure, because the castle gives us more HP and also the MP, but the MP we don't use it. That we discard at the moment. So there we go. This one we have reached. So 325. Maybe it tells us that we will reach this wave or near to this wave, but I'm not sure. So let's go here with the colonies and let's look how we do here. This should be easier, I think, because of the IF generator. The distance between the two castles is very slow, and there's almost half of the way or a third of the way which is blocked by the other castle. So this ones we should be managing very good with the IF generator here at the bottom left. 2000 HP left, and the castle is going down. Victory! Next one is 270 written there. I really don't know what it means. If for me, it looks like with the two swords that it's the strength that they have, or how strong the castle is. But I don't know where to look, where I can watch how fast or how strong my castle is. So the only way I can compare it is on the level of the wave, I think. So for me, it tells me more like if you are at wave 300, you will reach it. But probably the game is there also thinking that you play the normal way and use all your heroes, upgrade all your heroes, so that you don't start farming a lot. And yeah, we are doing completely false in the game's eye, I think. Only with archers, the battle tank, chemist, and the IF generator. I don't think that it was meant, because they put all the effort to put us so many slots here for other things, and we don't use it. We really don't use it. There's, for example, on my main account, I use the arcane focus, which is like a cannon which shoots arcane laser beam, I would say, yeah, something like that, where it does a lot of damage, really a lot of damage I have caused there with the bosses. I think I'm at 120,000 per hit. So that's really doing a lot of damage. And here we have nothing. We just need these archers and IF generator. I think he will also do a lot of damage here at the beginnings, because it is doing, I think, 30 or something like this from damaging the enemies. And if we are slow, low in the level, it means also that the enemies have less life, and with less life, they will have also the possibility to die faster by the IF generator, because they still get hit by him when they are inside. But we are doing pretty good. I don't see any archers coming outside, so we are quite safe here, I would say. We don't lost any HP, so that's perfect for us and means we can go to the next level. There we go, 2000 left. And still no loss of life. 360 here. We lost at the other one 325, if I'm not mistaken. So I really don't know what this number means. I just imagine. So there we go. Sometimes it does really fast the damage, or on the other castle now we have the half one. And sometimes it's just attacking all the arrows to the monsters which are coming out, and the castle damage is going slowly down. And you see, like, one or two arrows are going to hit the castle. If all enemies are down, you see a lot of archers throwing their into the castle. Also, this one, easy way. Victory. We already get every 60 second 14,000 of gold. Pretty good. So if we do nothing, we just get gold by staying there. For example, overnight I leave the phone open with the game and it is working. I get gold. Don't click something. So that's pretty good. When you close the phone, then you don't get nothing. Or the application, then it's only when you are in the game that you receive gold. Otherwise, you don't get something. I don't know if it's good or if it's bad. For sure, it would be better for the gamers that they get also during the AF key time. So, yeah. But in my opinion, I don't see it very disturbing here at this game. It's also always the repeating of the waves that you see. For example, here with these colonies, you are doing the same. It's the same castle, or not always the same castle, but the monsters are going to your castle and you have to destroy the other castle. If there are different monsters coming, or if they are stronger or not, yeah, that's a point where they change. The castle, the map will also change, but the principle of the game, it's the same. So you are doing exactly the same. If you have a lot of heroes here, you can tell them the special attacks, which is using MP. So that helps you to advance. I don't know if faster, but further for sure. Because I like to play the game not having to look all the time at it if I'm doing it hands-free. So if I'm on the wave and repeat, I just click always repeating. I keep on the finger on it, And like this, I can repeat the wave. But if I lose the wave, that I don't like. So I need to be strong enough in order to repeat the wave and also win the wave without clicking all the time at every hero. And for sure, if you play auto mode with the heroes on the castle, you will get much further because it's used the MP automatically in order that you can also advance further. In this case here, we will not have this issue. So we either way we got it or we don't got the wave. And the other way, you have possibilities of matching at the right time the right attack that you are able to get through the wave, and like this you go further. But this one also looks pretty good. I don't see there any problem to get further. So here, and after the weekend, when we farmed a lot of gold and we know where we are, we will upgrade the last one, which is giving us more gold, because I want them maxed out. As soon as I got them maxed out, I know, okay, I don't need to take care of that anymore. Also, the ones in the gear, I want to max it out in order to get it out of the way. Otherwise, yeah, oh, I have there at the towers, I need to upgrade something here at the heroes, and there, like this, we have it sorted out by doing it everything maxed out, what we can max out, like the battle tent, the gemist, they are already maxed out, so there we have nothing to do anymore. The archer castle and the hive generator, we can upgrade them by with the gold, so there we can still go further. But in the town, we got the maximum of level 3, and 3 or 4 we have already maxed out. And at the gear, I'm not sure how it was there, but we can have a look. I just noticed we had some damage. I cannot say which one were attacking us, if it were archers or enough monsters which came too close to our castle. Probably enough monsters which are going too close to our castle. And probably the big ones here, because they are the one which are going quite close to our castle. But also this one, we should be able to go through it. Left, 120, and the victory is on our side. And here we are at 406. I think I will not do it longer, because we got already 24 minutes recording, and then we continue next Monday and look how we do till where we got. So here we can upgrade this to level 21, and we got 33 of them. If you look now, maximum we got 4,700. Before we had almost 9,900. The airship is coming here, gives us 19,000. That's very good. We have a talent point which we can spend here, and this too we received. And we have the next here coming to us. Archer range, that's something very important for us, because we only use them. Here, critical chance of all the units, that means also the archers. And yeah, I hope we reach soon level 481 in order to unlock this one with the Paragon points. Here also we received the rocks here. this one we can upgrade. Let's upgrade to 5. This one I can also upgrade to 10. That's perfect. This one not able. This one we have already at 10. And this one also not able. So I think next time, before we spend the gold, we go for this in order to max it out. Probably there we will have some issues with the elixir. But I would say thank you for watching. Leave a like if you liked what you saw. Leave a comment if you want something additional to see, or what's good, what's not good. But either way, thank you very much for watching. Have fun and a nice weekend. See you later. Bye bye.